Nick Palumbo with RXMuscle.com in the Art Asylum with Derek Poundstone. We're here in the off season training chest and back at Jakked Hardcore Gym in Montgomery, Illinois. Welcome, Derek.
Thanks, Dave.
Well, we're out here at Bros vs. Pros 9, last man standing. This is the day before, and we got you in here at the gym. You had to get a quick workout in. You know, never one to miss a workout, Derek. And I guess the back was hurting a little bit, so we decided to do a little chest today.
Yeah, you know, I want to check out, anytime I go, I travel, I obviously like to check out the local gyms, but this place was no exception. You know, it was a fantastic facility. I mean, I've been to a lot of gyms in the world, and probably one of the most hardcore gyms I've ever been to, Dave. It was fantastic.
Now, you're probably less than 12 weeks, I would think, out from the Arnold Strongman competition, just about at that point, which is, I know, when you start really gearing up your training, getting the weights heavier, trying to put on some body weight, because the Arnold Classic, unlike some of these other, like the World's Strongest Man, is more of a strength competition, sheer brute strength.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm about 13 weeks out right now, so yeah, I mean, I've been, my training starts just kind of like you're seeing here. I mean, I think the core of all any athlete is really good sort of background in just typical weight training. So, you know, I think where I've lacked in the Arnold and basically in strongman in the past is my static strength. I'm really good with moving weight. I have a lot of finesse with overhead pressing and, you know, stones and stuff like that, but I really need to get my brute strength up a little higher. So that's been my focus this year, and this is what this workout's about, just pushing a lot of pounds for a couple hours.
Is this typically what your average pro strongman does in the gym? Is, do they concentrate mostly on weights? Are there some guys who do just the weird lifts?
You know, I think I'm a bit of an exception. You know, not necessarily the rule itself. You know, I enjoy weight training. I mean, you know, I just like lifting weights. And if it's, you know, heavy dumbbell pressing, or if it's, you know, lifting stones, doesn't make a difference. And again, I think the core for any aspiring strongman is to have a really good background in just weightlifting, just moving weight, you know?
Yeah, I mean, you kind of look kind of like Marius Pudzianowski did back when he was in his heyday. You had the bodybuilder-ish looking physique. I mean, you're a guy who trains arms. Now, I don't know many strongmen or powerlifters who train arms. You kind of like the complete development of the physique.
I'm a strongman. I'm not just, you know, stone lifting, car walking, frame carrying man. I'm a strong man. I think part of that is being strong in everything. I want to be well versed in anything. And if it's something from, you know, curling a lot of weight, and, or there's carryover as well. And I think, you know, being, you know, diversified so I can push a lot of weight on incline as I'm doing here, or I can, you know, do chin-ups, for instance, which I do later on in the video. You know, it doesn't make a difference what I want to do. I just think that guys should be able to, you know, lift in powerful ways, anything, you know, and I think that's the big thing that separates me from a lot of the other athletes.
Now, I have to ask you a question. I think this gym, Denim Dan, was telling us a little bit about Jakked Hardcore. He's involved with putting some of the weights together there, yeah. Some of the strongman equipment and the dumbbells, and he was bragging about, I think they had a 280-pound dumbbell set.
No, what happened was they actually have 200-pound dumbbells that go all the way up from 200 pounds up to 265 pounds in 5-pound increments.
Which is unheard of.
That's just unbelievable. So here I'm still warming up right now. These are 150-pound dumbbells. So these are the traditional largest Ivanko dumbbells you see at the gym.
Right.
So every set beyond this are dumbbells made by Illinois NAS, North America Strongman Society, state rep. Denim Dan, as he's known to, is just a really hardcore powerlifter, strongman athlete. So you'll see the next set of dumbbells are all handmade.
Now, these are the 190s. I think Denim Dan put these together, right?
Absolutely. This is, and I asked him because I'm interested in making also some larger set of dumbbells because I think there's a big use for them. You know, where he got the plates, and he just had been collecting them for the last 10 years. He, you know, some guys collect watches. I have a couple of buddies that are, you know, big watch collectors.
Right.
He collects plates and large dumbbells, which is kind of a cool little
yeah, especially when you're trying to put together a 200-pound dumbbell. Now, the problem with some of these dumbbells is once the plates, you add too many on, they get very long, and then they almost become unwieldy. You can't put them together. You have to hold them almost in a neutral type grip.
Yeah, and the bolts that hold them together are very large, and you'll see the look on my face on these next, you know, sets. It's quite a interesting look because it's, yeah, not a very good feeling.
Well, we got Byron, the gym owner of Hardcore here, Jakked Hardcore is helping you out here get these up. And you do a pretty good job getting them up yourself. I'm pretty impressed. Usually people need to get handed them to them. But I guess in your field, if you can't lift them up yourself, you're kind of defeating the purpose of strongman.
Yeah, and that was still – what you see here is I'm actually apologizing to Byron because I was like, I'm not dropping those nasty, big nut dumbbells on my on my legs because that would hurt like a bastard.
Right,
so
right.
Byron said absolutely when you lift that amount of weight. And there's Denim Dan himself.
Denim Dan grabbing the 225. He's very proud of his progeny that he created.
He was excited. He's actually the first time they've ever been pressed. So he was really curious to see if the handles are rated for 200 pounds a piece. So he was curious if his monstrosity there with the big bolts would actually hold.
It's like a Frankenstein monster he created, right?
It was cool, and I would have done these on. I would have gone up to flat, maybe up to 250 to 265, which I'm very confident I could have done on flat. But my back was hurting. There's no way I could kick those back into the total flat position. So
I mean, just to give people an understanding, the 225s on an incline bench, and you do use a very steep incline. This is almost like, a partial shoulder press. This is a very hard lift.
I had to do it on a steep incline because my back was hurting. That's what I was explaining to Dave, who was in the background here. For some reason, you never end the video.
Yeah, I try to stay out of the action, I'm just an instigator in the background.
But you'll notice is I didn't ask Denim for a lift, so
you kicked him up yourself, yeah.
I kicked him in, and I was like, hey, can I get a lift off? And he's like, yeah, sure, okay.
And then he gave you a little too much, I think, right?
No, he was fine. He was fine. It just was a tough sort of dumbbell to press. I mean, it was... they're very, very heavy and very, very
and look
long.
How wide apart you are. I mean, from your body, you had to come kind of further than you probably would normally come.
Yeah, no, it was painful. The last one he helped me, the first one not really, but it's just they're such unwieldy beasts. It was pretty cool. It was pretty fun to mess around with
them. Now, normally, what would you do? You'd bring the dumbbells and you hit your legs with them to kind of kill the momentum.
Yeah,
I did
that on the 190s, but I really couldn't do it with the heavier weight, the 225s, it would have destroyed my quad.
So explain to me, you went up to the 225s, now you went back down to the 190s. You have a whole theory of fiber recruitment. Give us a little taste of that.
It's a new theory that me and my coach, Tom Schiaffleone, are working on. The whole idea is to recruit as much fiber as possible. So you get some of the more gross motor skill fibers enacted in the early part of lifting. So it's this whole real long philosophy about the idea of when guys sort of burn out, if I would have done the 190s, I'm capable of so much more. If I would have done those to failure, it would have really been a waste because the 225s recruited every single muscle fiber in my chest, triceps, shoulders, even biceps. So the whole point was to do the 225s, get some reps in there when I was, relatively fresh, get as much fiber recruitment as possible, and then to go down to the 190s and do several working sets once I had sort of pre-fatigued the entire chest.
So it seems like you've got to the deepest level of fiber with the 225s, and then when you couldn't do any more of that, then you went back down.
Yeah, and now from here you can see I'm really digging deep, and the cool thing is every set sort of seemed like it got better, after the 225, and that's the whole point,
Now, the 190s, when you initially did them on the way up, I guess it was just to maybe get your nervous system used to that?
Yeah, it was, I was warmed up at that point physically. I mean, my core temperature was high enough. The muscle had been worked enough in the 150s. It was more of a central nervous system coordination movement just to really feel the weight on my central nervous system. And here, this is kind of my first warm-up set for the chin-ups. My lower back was bothering me quite a bit, so I couldn't do any sort of rowing events. So I just decided I only did a couple sets of chin-ups, and I was supersetting this with a bench press.
Now, you weigh how much right now?
325 right now.
At 325, you can do how many chin-ups the most, would you say?
I'd say 15.
Which is pretty impressive. A lot of people, most people at 250 pounds can't do chin-ups.
Yeah, I mean, you can see I'm using a little bit of momentum. Nothing too crazy, but I've got big, thick arms, and I definitely use a little bit of biceps on the chin-ups.
Now, I noticed you're not using any straps on this. Is that typical for your back movements? You try to do them with just
bare
hands?
Never straps, Dave. The whole point behind, strongman training is to develop every muscle to the most of my ability, so I can get everything as strong as possible. So this was just an attempt to... work my grip as well as my back.
So if they ever have a pull-up contest at the World's Strongest Man, you will probably win.
I would hope so, and if I did get beat, it'd be by the lighter guys, which I would be able to beat on the other events.
That's
so
true.
It wouldn't be too bad.
Right, now you moved over here. You're kind of doing like a little superset back and forth, back and chest. You went down to the flat bench, which you're doing last, which is kind of unusual. A lot of people usually start with the flat bench.
Again, because I got full fiber recruitment, so at this point I'm, every set I do is, I'm pretty much pre-exhausted at this point. So, plus they had a really nice bench. Normally at this point would have done floor presses, but they have this bench that's made by Metal Militia. It's covered in this sort of diver suit neoprene, and you can see I'm actually driving my legs forward. People talk about leg driving, and people think that you're actually driving your butt off the pad. I'm actually not. I'm driving my legs forward, and you'll watch it with this set here. It caused my body to rock back, and I'm able to generate a huge amount of power.
So that's good.
Yes, it's good. It's called leg drive. You actually see as I drive, I'm driving my shoulders into the pad, and my butt is just sliding backwards, creating a little bit more of an arch.
It's just
able to generate a whole lot more power as that rocking motion sort of takes place.
Is there a specific name for this bar too? Was this one of the special
bars?
No,
just a regular bar, just a really cool bench. So now what I'm doing here is I'd warmed up my back with that one set of chin ups, and now I'm in a superset chest with back. Right here, so I'm going to be benching, and the only thing I can really do at this point, because my back was bothering me, was obviously chin-ups, so I would just be benching superset with sit-up with chin-ups.
So now 405 on the bench right here, this is not a lot of weight for you, I would take it.
Typically this is not a lot of weight, but my first set here is, it's a little off. I just think going from incline to flat, I have that sort of feeler set where it just feels kind of weird. Only did a couple reps here. But as I work out, you'll see I get a little stronger. So now, but I'm supersetting it right straight into chin-ups, which I always find is, push-pull, I have a really good, I get better and stronger through the workout by doing this.
It seems like when you pump the back up, the chest gets stronger and vice versa.
Yeah. So that was my first set of real benching, but I hadn't done my chin-ups for, at this point, about 5 minutes, so.
Gotcha. Now talk to me a little bit about, we're going to see you go back to the bench in a minute, your bench press technique. As we were talking about before, a lot of bodybuilders, when they bench press, they keep their elbows out to the side, just, adjacent to their body. You have a different philosophy of where the elbow should be held when pressing on a bench press. Tell me about it.
Okay, now that I'm benching, I think I'm actually explaining to you right now, in the video.
Yes.
One of the big things here is when you watch, when I come down, a lot of bodybuilders bring their arms, so they come down perpendicular to their shoulders. So basically, there's a lot of shoulder recruitment, but it puts a huge amount of force on the shoulder joint itself. When I get the lift off here from Denim Dan, I'm bringing the bar so it actually comes down to lower pec level, and my arms are coming down closer to a 45 degree angle. And I'm actually getting more pec recruitment. I'm able to drive with more triceps. Plus, on the lockout, if you can see, once I'm actually locked out, the weight is no longer pushing my triceps unlocked. And it's funny because it's more of a powerlifting style of benching. So again, when I'm all, the bar is totally on my chest, it makes about a 45 degree angle with my upper torso. And what that's doing is actually incorporating more chest, which is much safer.
Is that taking the shoulder joint out of the movement too? Because I probably have injured my shoulder joints, probably in part because I was always a bencher that kept my arms perpendicular to my body.
Yeah, and that's the whole point, is it disassociates the shoulder to a larger degree and actually incorporates your back, believe it or not, because when you come down, it squeezes your shoulder blades quite a bit. And
yeah.
So you're unflaring your back, and then when you start the bench, you're actually flaring your back out, almost like a mini lat spread.
Mm.
This is actually a better set, I think you'll understand here. And as the workout goes on, I'm getting stronger and stronger.
Which is unusually. I noticed you've done like three sets of 405, which is, you would think most people would get fatigued at this point and get nervous about maybe hurting themselves.
Yeah, no, and then from here you can see I'm moving the weight a lot easier. That's just typical of strongmen because we train for hours on end. We compete for hours on end. So this is one of my better sets here. And you can see really that arm angle is much better there. Good spies, not let me. I hate when guys let you, you sort of struggle for too long. And this is you, Dave, asking for
a little.
I made
you hit some poses. I mean, your arms look like they're 24 inches, so I had to get you to hit a couple shots for us. We might see you on a bodybuilding stage someday. I wanted to give a little foreshadowing. We could show your first bodybuilding.
Funny, behind me, there's actually this big sign. If you can't really see it there, Byron's not a big bodybuilding fan. He says, no posing.
I didn't even see that.
It's got a big black sort of tape thing over it, so it's pretty
we
fun.
Violated his rules Jakked Hardcore. And for more on Derek Poundstone, we can check out, what's your website?
My website's poundstonepower.com.
Poundstonepower.com. And he has a radio show every Wednesday night on Sirius Satellite. That's what channel?
It's Sirius 94 XM 208. For the rest of the year, we're broadcasting from 7 o'clock to 9 o'clock on Wednesday nights. We broadcast live. You were on our show live last week. And what we'll do is begin the new year. We've been preempted by some of the Penn State games and the basketball games. So now we're going live from 6 to 8 p.m.
All right. Well, Derek, it was great seeing you again this weekend. We'll see more from him in the future. For now, we're out of time. I'm Dave Palumbo with Derek Poundstone in the Iron Asylum.